Any modern web or mobile application must have a user authentication mechanism. There are a lot of ways an application can authenticate users. In this video, I'll show how to implement classic login password session-based authentication on the server side with Node.js, MongoDB, and Passport.JS middleware. Let's consider what session-based authentication by login and password looks like. The client sends to the server login request with username and password. The server authenticates the login request, retrieves information about the user from a database, and creates a user session. The session identifier goes back to the client with cookies. Session ID as part of cookies will be attached to the every next request. This way, the server will know that request belongs to authenticated user. Passport.js is an authentication middleware for Node. It passes through itself every request from clients. Based on information from cookies, it associates an authorized request with a user session. In fact, it attaches user data to authenticated requests. To define how authentication will work, Passport.js uses strategies. You can find a lot of them on the official project website. To use strategy, you need to set up the NPM strategy package. For my case, I use username password authentication, and on backend I have Node Express.js, MongoDB with object data modeling library Mongoose.js. So for me, the best choice will be Passport Local Mongoose strategy. This is how my dependencies look for authentication with a Passport.js. Passport library itself with Passport Local Mongoose strategy and also types. Here is my Node Express application entry point. The app object is an Express framework instance. And in this point, we make the Passport.js auth library part of the middleware's chain. And on the next line, we set up work with the session. As I said before, the passport itself doesn't contain a low-level implementation of the authentication process. It uses strategy for this work. And here we say passport what exactly strategy needs to be used for user authentication. I will talk a bit later about why we use user model to produce the strategy. But for this moment, it's important to understand that any passport strategy can be put here depending on your needs and technical stack that you use. The next two lines are the methods we need to serialize the logged in user in the session and deserialize it back on subsequent requests. We also use user model static methods here. The user model class builds on the user scheme and aggregates logic related to the user document. The key thing here is that in this line we plug the passport local mongoose module into user scheme. This is a junction point where the passport local mongoose stuff comes into the play. The user model based on this plugged scheme will implement the passport local model interface. The passport local model interface extends the normal mongoose model interface, plus adds a new set of specific methods that we need to work with Passport.js authentication, like strategy, serialize and deserialize. We can go to the source code of Passport Local Mongoose module and see here how it extends the scheme of the user document. The main methods that I want to distinguish are authorization method that implements details of user authentication with username and password. Serialize user which puts data of authenticated user to session. Deserialize user that restores a user object from a session or database and attaches it to subsequent requests. And a register method that can be used for signup flow when we create a new user entity in a database. So if we go back to where we attach the Passport.js and set the strategy, we understand now why the user model gives us this functionality. Because the user model combines usual Mongo's functionality plus specific Passport.js methods. Let's consider on this picture how we add passport authentication functionality to the project. We are saying to the Express framework to apply passport middleware when calling the app.use method with passport instance as parameter. Initially, passport does not contain any authentication strategy and implementation for serialize and deserialize methods. In other words, the passport does not know how to practically authenticate users and work with the session. We take the strategy, serialize and deserialize methods from the local passport mongoose plugin. The plugin functionality is attached to a user scheme and available via user model static methods. So now we can set up details of implementation for the passport. Let's look at what the user serialize and user deserialize functions are. They are both pretty straightforward. The serialize user function defines what information will be kept in session and saves it by calling the callback function. In this case, after successful login, just a username goes to the session. The deserialize user defines how we retrieve user objects. Here we use a mongoose model to find a user in the database by username. The user object will be attached to authorized request in the callback function. Look at my implementation of the authentication endpoint. This is my login controller, and it takes the static passport instance as a constructor parameter. We call the authenticate method on the passport instance with two parameters. The first is the name of an auth strategy that we want to use. We need this because in theory the passport can use different strategies in one application. And the second parameter is a callback function. In this function, we can place our custom logic to handle success or failed cases. For example, for some successfully logged user, we still need to send an 401 error back because user email isn't verified. The main idea here is that when we call the authentication method on a passport instance, under hood the passport takes the right strategy by the name and call authentication method on that strategy. The use of different authentication strategies with the passport framework is a good example of a behavior design pattern strategy. The strategy pattern suggests that you have a class that does something specific in many different ways. But the algorithms for performing these actions are wrapped in separate classes called strategies. The class uses strategies called context. It has a field for storing a reference to the strategy. The context isn't responsible for selecting an appropriate algorithm for the job. Instead, the client passes the desired strategy to the context. In our case, the context is the passport class. And the client is an Express application that sets up a strategy for the passport by calling the use method on it. The passport as a context class doesn't know much about strategy implementation. The only thing that is important for it is that a strategy implements an authentication interface. From the perspective of the clean code design principles, the passport and strategies is a good example of the open-close-solid principle. Components should be open for extension, but closed for modification. And we see that the passport class is open to extension with new strategies without need to be modified itself. The other solid principle that also works here is dependency inversion. A high-level model, in our case the passport class, should not depend on low-level models, strategies. Both should depend on abstraction. And they do because our abstraction is the strategy interface, which requires the authenticate method to be implemented. Let's back from patterns to passport middleware. It binds the request that comes in with a user session based on cookies. If the request belongs to an authenticated user, the passport attached to it a user object that will be available for next middlewares. And here we need a deserialization function to retrieve the user object from the database based on the session information. Here in my controller, I directly take an authenticated user from the request object, and this user was attached by Passport.js middleware. Register is another method that is implemented by Passport Local Mongoose plugin and attached to user model. It creates a new user with a passport in the database. I'm using the register method in my signup flow. I call it inside my repo class that is responsible for communicating with the database. The main benefit that I get from using this method over the normal Mongoose creation is that it implements a special security mechanism and creates a password with a salt. The salt is random data that is added to a password string before to hash it with a cryptographic function. Without salting, the same password strings will have the same hashes. So if a hacker has a stolen password table, he can easily iterate each hash and compare it with a pre-calculated hash table. If a match is found, a password is cracked. With salt, we can mitigate this type of attack. Because for every random and unique salt string, a potential attacker needs to generate a new hash table. In this video, I showed how to use Passport.js for session-based login password authentication. But Passport.js is a very universal thing for user authentication with a variety of different strategies that ship with useful security things like password saltings, or prevent too often attempts to log in. You can use it with JWT and OAuth standards, popular third-party authentication APIs like Google and Facebook, and many more.